This is flag banner. This is a Fisher flag banner. Lots of flag banners. What distinguishes it, if you hold it up to the light, there's lots of little holes. This is a mesh. Even more holes. That's actually a flag too. This one's the mesh. This is a mesh. This is a Top Value Fabrics mesh. Prints nicely. Now, one of the big advantages of a 360 and 370 is they have an ink collector. And the purpose of the ink collector is when you run mesh or flag banner or georgette, anything fabric that has pinholing. If you hold it up to the light, light shines through, ink will go through, you collect it on the ink collectors. These are your ink collectors. That's the advantage of the 360 and 370's ink collector system. So my recommendation for mesh or flag is you don't want to order stuff that has a liner. You don't need a liner. Now you can use a liner, and there's some materials like some shears that have a liner, but keep in mind that when you're printing to material that's been attached to a liner, that the liner is usually paper, and the liner has its own characteristics. Fabric has very different characteristics. So you now you have two things that are very unlike one another merged together with adhesive. And depending on how old the adhesive is or how long the roll's been around or a lot of other factors, what can happen is the mesh and the liner work at cross purposes. Because if you're printing, for example, on fabric, on a liner, really what you're trying to do is print on heavy paper with fabric on top of it. So you're kind of going to almost choose a paper workflow because the fabric is going to perform very differently when it's on top of a paper. Same with mesh. I recommend printing with mesh. We have a nice mesh from Ultraflex, which is certified on the media locator for the 360 and 370. There are also meshes out there that have liners. Well, the liner and the mesh can be difficult. It's something that doesn't always work as bulletproof as you'd like. It definitely is much easier to print directly just on the mesh and use the ink collectors, which is my recommendation. Now, with a 330 and the 310, you don't have an ink collector. In those cases, if you're going to print on mesh, you have to use a liner. But just be aware that there can be difficulties with using a liner. You may have to try a couple companies to find one that works well. It's not the most ideal thing to print on. Fabric tends to work a little better when it's put onto a liner, but it's tough. I'd much rather if you're printing on a fabric on a 330 that you would find a fabric that's airtight or tightly woven so you don't have to use a liner. But definitely for mesh, particularly like banner mesh, I would recommend choosing one in the locator, picking one that's certified, and use the ink collectors. Don't put it on a paper liner. Just a personal recommendation based on what I know the printers can do.